Hi guys, it's Sunday and I hate Rubik's Cubes.
I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
I know I look like crap, that's because it's 10 PM and it's freezing out, but I'm gonna Rubik's Cubify now.
A land of vast distances and rich natural resources, Canada became a self-sufficient dominion in 1867, while retaining ties to the British Crown. Economically and technologically, the nation has developed a parallel with the U.S., its neighbor to the south, across an unfortified border. Canada faces the political challenges of meeting public demand for quality improvements in healthcare and education services, as well as responding to separatist concerns in predominantly Francophone Quebec. Canada also aims to develop its diverse energy resources while maintaining its commitment to the environment. We have a total area of 9,984,670 square feet, of which 9,093,507 square feet is land, and 891,163 square feet is water. We are the second biggest country in the world.
Chase, I started at 10 p.m. It is now 11:44 p.m. It is dark outside. It is very cold, and I am tired. No more Rubik's Cube. On the topic of Rubik's Cubes, I've decided that I'm going to try to solve the Rubik's Cube by the time the year is out. I've never really done anything that I can think of that I would need to get away with the cops from.
Who's a pretty kid?
Okay, it's not really something I had to get away with, but it is a funny story. So I was on a trip to Boston with my grade 9 band, right? Well, not my grade 9 band, it was senior band, but I was in grade 9. So we were on the trip to Boston, we were at the border going into the U.S., so going from Ontario to New York. And the police get on the bus and walk up and down the aisles to see if, you know, we're going to try and bomb anything with our bass clarinets and trumpets, which I guess would be a really good place to hide a bomb now that I think of it. And then this one cop stops right beside me, and I'm on the aisle seat. Here's the cop, and here's another seat. The cop is facing... If it were you and me, it would be facing you. And the gun was right beside my head. And there was two voices in my head. There was one, oh my god, it's a gun, hide. And the other one was, oh my god, it's a gun, I bet I could, like, grab that. Luckily, I didn't try and grab the gun because that would have been bad. But I was very, very close to trying. My challenge is to make your video with no clip longer than 30 seconds. So you have to make a lot of cuts in your video. I'm currently reading a lot of books. More Information Than You Ever Need to Know by John Hodgman, who's on The Daily Show. The Shadow in the North by Philip Pullman. The first book of this series was The Ruby and the Smoke. It was a very good book. I finished that.
That's
Wednesday. Chase? No clips longer than 30 seconds. See you tomorrow, Rachel.